Okay, so I still have glass everywhere in the truck. I can't physically go out there and suck it up, which would tear my vacuum cleaner up, whereby I'm not going to do that crap. So anyway, it's in the floor, it's in the seat, it's in the dashboard, it's in the back seat. I mean, Ashby had a heyday doing what he did. He just could not wait to get here on my property and damage my truck. But anyway, because Morris was already to the left of me, and, you know, he was already talking to me. I already had my door open. There wasn't any call for Ashby to knock my daggone window out. That's all right. I mean, you know, they got a lot coming at them. And, you know, compensation will be had. You know, they've opened a can. They're going to wish they'd never opened. But this was all sent. I think I've already said that and showed that, so I won't rehash it. But y'all need to stand up. The bullshit that's going on in this country against good people and against man and woman, you're not a citizen. You never were. But until you become an American state national, they think that you're under their rule and thumb. And I already read case law from the United States Supreme Court that they have nothing to do with us. They are the dead entities. They are corporations. They cannot contract with the living. That's why that similarity name that you keep claiming in the all capital letters that you think is you, when it has nothing to do with you. Okay? They cannot come at you in the private side. All right? So all this derived from me filing a non-commercial private lien against the Liberty Mutual, my workers' comp insurance, that has imprisoned me in my house 30 plus years. So they call the heavies, the district attorney, whatever the hell his title is, and, you know, which is also corporate. So you have the state helping the insurance company, all right, because they're corporate. Everything, and when you all go into their Mickey Mouse kangaroo court, you have judges that are paid by the state. You got the prosecuting attorney paid by the state. You have the freaking attorneys working for the state and working in they're officers of the court, okay? Even the ones that you're paying, they're officers of the court. Good luck with that. All right, do you not see clearly the writing on the wall that it's all a setup deal? It's all biased against you. It's to get money out of the SUSKV trust under the all caps name, and your body is the surety for the damn SUSKV trust. That's why so many people in America are locked up, because they're gleaning millions and billions of dollars off of our Social Security numbers. Okay? Not for the private side. They're doing it for right in your face. You know? I mean, it took me a long time to discover and learn what I know. 21 years of it or better. So, you know, we are the living people. They cannot contract with you unless you consent. And by damn, I do not consent. Never have, never did, never will. So they are commerce. They can give the taxi drivers a ticket, the semi-trucks, the food industry, little runabout utility trucks that deliver Hostess cupcakes, whatever the heck, okay? And the buses and other cops or sheriff department. Of course, they're not going to give themselves tickets. We know that. But, you know, they think that they are under the law or answerable to the laws, that they're sworn to abide and uphold, okay? They got into that. I didn't bend their arm or twist it and say, hey, become a public servant. But, you know, they have such disdain against we the people because they treat us like we're mud on the bottom of their shoe. That's exactly what they do. And they're all in the club, like George Carlin said, you know. They got their fucking club. You're not a party of it. You never were, okay? And they don't give a shit about you. It's all about the Cesta KV Trust. And the daggone people, because then I filed the other case on a non-commercial lien from the private side, from the living woman, against the electric company for them gleaning money from the Cesta KV Trust and breaking the public law 7310, public law 10, public law 1, the Libra Code, the Trading with the Enemies Act. I mean, this is our government calling them what they're doing is embezzlement, mail fraud, fraud by deception. And there was another one. Regular fraud, fraud by deception. Or theft by deception, I'm sorry. And mail fraud and embezzlement. So, I mean, these are all felonies, okay, people? But the utility companies, your gas, your electric, your phone service, and your internet service, they're all prepaid for under the Bankruptcy Act of 1933 and the House Joint Resolution 192 and House Resolution 1491. Go look it up. Do your research. They're ripping you off. And if you don't pay them a second time, then they end up threatening you, intimidating you to come and shut off your daggone utilities, when they do not have the lawful right to do so. So that's coercion, that's RICO racketeering, malfeasance, breach of public trust, and a whole lot more. Okay? Hold your utility companies accountable. I did, and what did it get me? But arrested. But there's some people watching these cases. Okay? And I'm not going to go into that. But, there, you know, it's more than just me, I can assure you. But anyway, I'm done for the night. I'm tired. I want to get these all finished and uploaded. I've done lost count how many videos it is. They're supposed to last 27 minutes with this Nikon camera, because they still have my damn Sony camera. You know, the evildoers, the ones that brought this down around my ears, because it was all a setup deal, folks. You know, you had the little guy at the McCarty towing and auto repair stuff or shop that ended up, y'all remember, about a year ago when they came and stole Grand Theft Auto, stole my truck off of my property when I was using it for a sound barrier by the little creek next door. That the little creep next door is also shooting at my daggone service dog. But nobody's doing anything to stand up against the tyranny or treasonous actions and oath breakers that are running this town. Except for me, you know. So we'll see where this pans out, because they will be held accountable. And I just want it to be peaceful, live my daggone life, and, you know, being totally disabled, homebound, being forced here by Liberty Mutual, who's in breach of their daggone court orders. They're in contempt of their court orders. But the Department of Worker Claims is all up in there, too. I mean, the sheets are dirty, folks. They're all in bed together. The judges, the cops, everybody in the Supreme Court. Justice Judge Dale ended up verifying this fact. He spilled the beans on it. Go read it. All right? So, you know, they're doing all this for the Cesta KV Trust. That's what it's all about. It's about them getting the money, getting the money, getting the money. I urge you to turn the names in of your city or town officials, because they're doing the same daggone thing. Turn them in to the IRS, because they're for damn sure not paying taxes on it. So when they glean their butts with a flashlight for the past 7 years of how in hell they're going to account for all this money that they've been stealing, okay, then there'll be some questions asked. You understand? So, okay, y'all have a good night. Take care. Stay safe. Send me your prayers if you have a mind to. Yeah. All right. Thank y'all. Take care, Carol.